All right, so good afternoon, students. Once again, we are here in the class presentations and we are doing the topic-wise presentation of a lot of topics. And if some child is particularly interested in presenting another topic, he or she may ask me later. I shall definitely give him a chance. Now, today we have our group, which is Group Lucknow. And the offline students are supposed to be quiet and calm. Even if the discussions are going on, it should be at the whisper or the murmur mode. So let me switch on the camera. Yeah. Yes. Now, yes, please start your presentation, Group Lucknow. Okay.
The poem beautifully captured the moment of the much.
Durgesh, you need to open your camera. Yeah. Yeah, now it is. Now it is. Please, please continue. Continue, Durgesh.
The near and million objects around us, which is today's time, are a very essential part of experience. The poem discusses the movement of juggling fan. The poem discusses the sound made by the jeans and comparing to human gender. Not allowing the impression.
See, one by one, the group members, the harmony and the like the tuning among the group members should be such that if one has stopped, the other should begin after the previous person has stopped. Keep a hand on your mouth, Aditya, else no any animal can go inside your cave. Right? So yes, Durgesh has stopped. Another group member is supposed to be active.
Can I also read the poem?
No, right now we are not, you know, we are the purpose of this activity is people can teach. You don't have to read and to show. You have to explain. आपको पढ़ाना है, ठीक है ना? तो उस पे फोकस कैसे हो पाएगा? तो सबको चांसेस इवनली मिलने चाहिए, राइट? Who is the next member of your group?
So now we are going to tell the question answers. So first question is, what is
right. Who else?
The full balance. What do you think the talking fan was demanding? So the answer of third one is the talking fan was demanding for oiling its little whirling motor. The fourth one is, how does an electric fan manage to throw so much air when it is switched on? The electric fan managed to throw so much air when it is switched on, as it gets a huge amount of power of electricity to rotate its whirling motor and move it as metallic so fast. So it's manage to throw so much of air when it switches on? If funnels, is there a talking fan in your house? Create a dialogue between fan and mechanic. Yes, I have a mechanic fan in my house. Mechanic, how are you doing? Fan, not well, suffering from a heat and friction. Can you do something? Mechanic, I will try to help you. Let me check you first. Fan, yes, sure, please do your best and help me. Mechanic, I will, please wait, let me finish my job. Fan, go ahead. After repairing, mechanic, now all is okay. Fan, yes, now I am feeling well. It feels so good. Mechanic, that is great. Remember me when you are in trouble. Fan, yes, I will. Thanks for helping me. Greetings to you, mechanic. You are welcome. Bye. Take care. Fan, bye. You do take care. Thank you.
So that's the presentation of our group.
All right, so that was Group Lucknow, and I think they all have done very well. I think the students were knowing that which part has to played by whom, right? So is there any individual child who want to present a certain topic from online class? Ankit? Rudra? Yes, you may.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Ankit Singh, and with my friend Rudra Shukla, we are going to start a presentation on the topic present tense. This is a topic of tense, which means time, and in the tense we understand about it. When the action, how when any subject is doing his action. And the first part of it is present tense. So I'm going to tell about simple present tense. Simple present tense, the structure of it is first the subject plus verb plus object. For example, I play. In this, I use subject and the verb. But I doesn't use object. It is option that in the sense, suppose you want it not to use object or not. And in this, important thing is that if the subject is plural, so we use, we doesn't use S or ES with verb. And if the subject is singular, we use ES or S with verb. For example, he eats the apple. In this, the subject is singular, thus we use S with E. And now I want to call Rudra for the explanation for the continuous tense, simple present continuous tense.
It should not be simple. Mm-hmm. It should not be simple. It is present continuous or present progressive. Okay. Yes, Rudra, begin.
Good morning, friends.
Good afternoon.
Good morning, friends. Good afternoon, friends. I am going to make my topic present continuous tense. So first of all, I will tell you about main things about the present continuous tense. So it is used to express an action going on at the time of speaking. For example, she is eating. It is in that at the time of speaking, she is eating. And the second information is to express a temporary action which may not be actually happening at the time of speaking. For example, she is learning to swim at the club these days. In this example, he is not speaking at the time. The action is not happening at the time of speaking. It is already happened, but the subject is telling about us now. And the third point is to indicate an action.
Offline bhi kona raha hai, aapke bhi mic pe.
It is the near future.
Mera group kon hai sunne wale?
Kar hi raha hu. Is not coming.
सबको बुलाऊंगी यहाँ पे एक एक करके सब
बोलेंगे
आधे कैमरे में नजर आएंगे कैमरे के सामने
और
What is the meaning of appreciate? Like if some students...
To motivate someone.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Continue.
And the third one is works of senses. That is see, smell, hear, taste, etc. Works of the position. Position means that it is mine. For example, position is arm, loan. And the last one is works like a PSC, consistently resemble are not used in present position. Thank you, and now my friend Ankit will continue.
Okay. I think I need to appreciate all the people who have come here in the seventh period, and they at least took this baton of presentation in their hands, and they spoke well, and they put their best foot forward in terms of their efforts for topic presentations. Now I would like to call the group of Delhi from your offline classmates, and the group members are Yuvraj, Shruti, can you get up, Shreesh, and what's your name, dear? Harsh, to take the stage. They'll be standing near the whiteboard. You all can see them in the cameras as well. One by one, they are also here to share their views about the topic. Yuvraj, take the mic and present. Stand there. Take the camera.
So today we'll be good afternoon, friends. Today we will teaching you the chapter called Chandni. Abu Khan kept goats as pets. He loved his goats, but they left him one by one. He bought a young goat and called her Chandni. Once upon a time, there lived an old man in Almora. Okay, I will asking you some questions from Chandni chapter. So first question is, why did Abu Khan's goat wants to run away? What happened to them in hills?
Anybody from offline class?
Anybody on offline class?
Offline.
I repeat. Why did Abu Khan's goat wants to run away? What happens to them in the hills?
Tanmay, you answer.
Abu Khan's goats wants to run away because he wants freedom to go to the hills, and Abu Khan don't want to left him because he was alone, and Abu Khan did not want to leave, and the goats left him and killed by the old wolf who lived in the hilly region. Ma'am, because freedom is our birthright, and freedom is our birthright, so we want all to, and it's our pride to be freedom, and we also want to be a freedom, because yes, ma'am.
Do you like people to lock them up in a cage?
No, ma'am.
Right? So nobody would love to be in a cage. We all need our freedom. If I ask you that you come with me my home and you stay there for 80 days, will you accept the offer?
No, ma'am.
All right. So that was what's happening with the goats.
So
now take another question and invite people from online.
So second question is for online classes. Abu Khan said, "No more goats in my house ever again." Then he changed his mind. Why?
Give any person chance of your choice.
Okay, Aditya, you answer. Okay, it was correct.
Now
I will like to call Shruti for second presentation.
Good afternoon, everyone. Now I am going to explain you the second part of Chandni chapter. Now we see in the chapter, in the last part, that Chandni, Abu Khan had many goats, and one by one every goat left him, and he was very exhausted as he was very alone. So when every goat leave him, he was very disappointed, and at last he said, "I will not have any goat." Then he said, "No, I should have, because I'm very alone and old. I want some company." So he bought a baby goat whose name he put Chandni. Now Chandni was growing day by day, and what was Chandni's routine was that Abu Khan told him stories of the goats, the goats who left and go in the forest for the freedom and were killed by the wolf. So he told these stories so that Chandni would not leave him. And Chandni was growing. So every day she used to see the sun in the hilltop. In the hilltops, and she was a hilly goat, and hilly goats want. So I want the question answers to be answered by both online and offline students. My first question is, why did Chandni hate the rope around her neck? Answer from online. Anybody from online can answer. Aryan, Ramesh. My question is, why did Chandni hate the rope around her neck? Shri Mishra, you can answer. Yes, this is the correct answer. Next question.
Nai Shri Mishra, for,
and this was the correct answer. Now we have second question.
All right, thank you so much. You all have been doing good job, and I'm so happy. And I hope you also have enjoyed.
Have you all enjoyed, online students, this presentation? Okay, thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, Shruti. So I just asked the question, if this method was liked and appreciated by you, I think this way we can have our future sessions. Yes or no? So that you all can remain awake by the last period, can look so beautiful before the cameras, can come and sit nicely, and can please me. Rudra, straighten your back. Nice. All right, so that's all for today. And I shall be bringing up more new ways tomorrow. Thank you.